Hey there! So today I have a story time for you. I really love doing story times, but I'm kind of boring, so not a lot happens. So when I get the opportunity to tell a story time, it's pretty awesome because I really like telling them. So for today, I have a story time about the crazy lady that I met in Target. I thought of this the other day. I think about it a lot, actually, which is probably not good, but I think about it mostly because I see the Targets all the time that are around here. I go in there a lot, and it's just always a reminder. Every time I see Target or a Target cart, I'm reminded of this incident. So let's just get right into it. I'm gonna let you know this lady was very crazy. So my mom, aunt, and I were going to Target because there was a really good sale on pop, and it was the cans of pop, and we used them for my dad at work, and my uncle takes them to work. So we're getting them for like all these like reasons, and we just wanted to get some pop. It was an innocent venture. So we get to the place and we grab a cart, and it was all good, you know, just grabbing a cart, having a good time. We go to the pop aisle, we start loading in pop. Then we realize we're going to need another cart, and it shouldn't be no big deal, right? Shouldn't be, anyway. So we have our cart and it's getting filled, and we're like, okay, this is too heavy, we need another cart. So we just decide, all right, let's look around, see if anybody has abandoned a cart, because it was like in like the back of the store. So it was like, what's the point of running up if we can find an abandoned cart? I go and start looking down all these aisles. Okay. I look down like 10 aisles, and in the middle of them is a cart in one of the aisles. So I think, okay, I'm going to check the surrounding aisles. And if nobody is here, the cart's probably abandoned, because people do that a lot in stores. So I wasn't surprised to see an abandoned cart. I look inside the cart. After checking all these aisles, I don't see anybody. There's just some eye drops in there. So I'm like, okay. I take those out. I go to meet my aunt and my mom with this cart. Everything's all good. We're just stocking the pop. And then this lady dressed in this like nice outfit, and like she had the like, can I speak to the manager haircut, if you know what I mean? She had like the bob and everything going on. She comes up to us. She gets like really close, and she comes like to my mom and my aunt. Like she kind of ignored me because I was just this kid. But she comes up to my mom and she goes, did you take my cart? And like in a mean way. And my mom was like, oh no, I'm sorry. Was this your cart? We thought it was abandoned in the other aisle. She's like, I'm sorry. Well, you can have your cart back. We apologize, you know. We start taking the stuff out of the cart to give it back. And we're apologizing. Sorry, we didn't see anybody in the aisles. We didn't realize it belonged to anybody. People usually abandon their carts. And this lady starts getting very nasty towards my mother and my aunt, and indirectly me, but obviously if she said something to me, I think my mom and aunt would have gotten a little more upset. They're like very calm in situations like this. Like nowadays, if this happened, ooh, that lady would have been in for a fun ride. But I was a shy kid, so of course I never said anything when it happened. Anyway, so this lady starts saying stuff like, you can't just take people's carts. Like, that was my cart. That was in the aisle. Like, how dare you? And we're just like, we're sorry, you know, and we're putting it back, and we apologized, and I'm kind of like struck by how rude this lady is acting. And I'm just kind of nervously putting the pop back, and this woman starts arguing even more. She's like, I should call the security on you or something. And I'm like, what? Why are you, what? Target doesn't have security. Like, what, do they? I don't know. This woman then proceeds to just start like yelling at us. People are like looking down the aisle because she's like yelling pretty much. And she's like, you took my cart, and that was my cart. And she kept repeating it over and over. And we're like, we're sorry. And then eventually my mom got a little heated. My aunt was more calm in this situation. My mom is like me. She can get pretty hot tempered at times. She has to have time to cool down before she can actually rationally think about something. And this woman was, you could tell my mom was getting really annoyed at this woman. We're putting the stuff back. Eventually, my mom just gets so irritated at this woman, and she starts kind of snapping back, like, we're putting your stuff back. You can stop now. Like, you're getting your cart back. And the woman, like, takes the cart, and, like, she was just trying to start a fight, basically. She saw us do something that she didn't like and was just trying to start a fight. And I remember just being so scared that this woman was, like, gonna mess up my life. As she's walking away, after my mom and my aunt had just kind of been like, whatever, lady. So this woman, as she's rounding the corner, she goes, you dress how you act, and then just disappears. And my mom just kind of looks at my aunt and I and goes, comfy? My mom does not like care how she dresses. She dresses to be comfy. Yes, she does look nice, of course, like that's a given, but she at least like looks for comfort in her clothes. And at this time it was like colder out, so we were wearing like jackets, like hoodies and stuff like that. So it's not like it was the nicest thing. Like, and this lady had some nice coat on. And I remember just being so irritated at this woman, but like at the time, like I just didn't want to say anything. She was like just screaming at us in Target, and we apologized several times. And yes, we probably should have looked better for whoever owned the car, but there was nobody within 5 aisles on either side, so I assumed it was abandoned. I didn't see anybody, but granted, I could have missed her. At the same time, she didn't need to act that way. She could have just been like, oh, it's no problem, just can I have my cart back, you know? And we were totally willing to give it to her, but she just started screaming at us. Anyway, I wish I could have said something. I'm very upset at myself for not actually saying anything to this insane woman. So if it happened today, I feel like I probably would have just been like, excuse me, lady, if you do not knock it off, you're going to cause me to just throw fists because you are yelling at me for something that I already apologized for and you are trying to cause a fight. If you want a fight is what you'll get, but you'll end up with a broken leg in the process. So I don't know why what you're doing, but honestly, today, I don't put up with stuff like that. Like, me as a kid was very shy and I didn't really want to interact with people, but now I would have been like, punch, punch, snap. So yeah, this woman was insane and I never ever want to meet her again. Not gonna lie, I probably would have swore a storm up at this woman because you don't just act like that. Like, I realized we did something wrong and we apologized for it. But the way she was acting, it was just so negative. I mean, it just bothers me how people can act so ridiculous about stupid things like that. And I don't know, it's just insane. So yeah, that's the story of the time I met a crazy lady in Target and she was just badgering my family and wouldn't leave us alone, all because we took her cart, which yes, we admit was wrong, but we didn't realize it was hers and usually people abandon carts. So it was just like, really, lady, you're gonna act like that? Anyway, this story time hopefully wasn't too boring for you. It was just one of those things in my mind that just bothers me so much when I go into Target and I just have to like spill it out or else I'm gonna lose my mind. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. I really enjoy making story times. Sorry my life's kind of boring because I wish I had more story times for you guys. I'm a homebody, so not a lot happens to me, but it is exciting when things happen to me. And like, it's funny how a lot of things would happen that I just was like too afraid to confront. And like, now it's like, I will cut you. Like, it's so weird how different it is. But anyway, hopefully you enjoyed this video. I really enjoyed making it. Please leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed. It means the world to me. Thank you so much for watching my videos. You are amazing, and I hope you have a great day. I'll see you in my next video.